11, 10, 9, 8, 7. We have a go for main engine start. 5, 3, 2, 1. We have booster ignition and liftoff of Space Shuttle Columbia with a multitude of national and international space research experiments.
Houston now controlling the flight of Columbia, the international research mission finally underway.
Roger, roll, Columbia.
Columbia now rolling on to the proper azimuth for a 39-degree inclination to orbit. Shuttle in a heads-down, wings-level position for the 8.5-minute ride to orbit. 30 seconds into the flight, the three liquid fuel main engines beginning to throttle back in a three-step fashion to 72% of rated performance, reducing the stress on the shuttle as it breaks through the sound barrier. Columbia already 2.5 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 4.5 miles in altitude. The main engines beginning to rev up to full throttle, 104% of rated performance.
Columbia, you send your go at throttle up.
We copy go at throttle up.
The throttle up call acknowledged by Commander Rick Husband, joined on the flight deck by Pilot Willie McCool, Flight Engineer Colton Achavla, and Mission Specialist Dave Brown. Mission Specialist Laurel Clark, Payload Commander Mike Anderson, and Payload Specialist Elon Ramon seated down on the mid-deck. 1 minute, 26 seconds into the flight, Columbia 10 miles downrange, 13 miles in altitude, traveling at 1,800 miles an hour. Away from solid rocket booster separation, everything looking good on board Columbia. Solid rocket booster separation confirmed. Guidance now converging. Columbia's onboard computers commanding the main engine nozzles to gently swivel, aiming the shuttle for a precise target in space for main engine cutoff. Columbia now 43 miles downrange, 35 miles in altitude, traveling 3,200 miles an hour. The propulsion officer and mission control reporting that the orbital maneuvering system engines have ignited, providing Columbia with a boost uphill for the next 90 seconds.
As you can see down in the lower left, there's Mike Anderson coming up from the mid-deck preparing for the ET photo that we're going to do once we pitch the orbiter up. And Dave Brown, there on the right, is getting out of his seat and getting his seat prepared to take some video of the external tank. Mike's taking pictures with the F5 camera, and Dave there is getting his parachute out of his seat, kind of getting everything out of the way so that he can then fold his seat down and get in a position to be able to take pictures of the external tank. You see Willie and I are congratulating each other up front there, and we were very happy to welcome four new astronauts into the community with Willie McCool, Dave Brown, Laurel Clark, and Elon Ramon. So you can see Dave's getting all squared away and ready. Mike handed him the video recorder, and Mike comes on up into the cockpit to get himself into position to take those photos. You can see with the launch and entry suit on that it's a bit of a challenge coming up and maneuvering and everything, but they're able to get in position anyway. Dave's making sure he's got all of his settings correct on the camera here, and then getting ready to take a look outside the window and film that external tank. We've got some clips of the external tank coming up here shortly. There's a good shot of the external tank just shortly after we pitched up, and we're looking at it through the overhead windows of the orbiter, as you saw Dave getting and Mike getting ready to do earlier. And you can see every once in a while some ice particles that are floating across the screen. And here now with some of the contrast in the clouds, you get a sense of the kind of speed that we're going here after MECO. Meanwhile, inside the cockpit, Kalpana Chawla MS-2 is busy helping myself and Willie get all of the checklist items done before we can get ourselves set up for the OMS 2 burn.
Columbia, Houston, we saw a good OMS 2 burn. No trim required. We'll meet you in the post-OMS 2. And to have a sensitive moment, we would like to welcome, or we hope your wait to space was worth it, and we saw a flawless ascent and insertion for your now veteran crew of astronauts, and especially a big welcome to Elon as you join the international community of human spaceflight.
Well, we thank you very much, Houston, and we made sure that we welcomed everybody to space, and they're all doing great. Thanks a million.
This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at live video coming from the Space Shuttle Columbia as Columbia continues to orbit the Earth at an altitude of about 150 statute miles. The Instrumentation and Communications Officer here in Mission Control now moving the cameras to look down the length of the payload bay of Columbia. The crew of Columbia, those seven members, continuing to go through all their on-orbit configuration, getting all the systems ready for their 16-day science mission. The Freestar pallet now coming into view, six experiments on that pallet. One of those experiments is the Mediterranean-Israeli dust experiment that's going to be used to measure small particles called aerosols in the atmosphere over the Mediterranean Sea as well as over the Atlantic Ocean just off the coast of the Sahara Desert. Also on that pallet is a space experiment module, the 14th such module, to fly on the space shuttle, and that contains 11 experiments from schools and educational programs across the United States. The students developed those individual experiments, went through all the work of figuring out how to send them up to the space shuttle, and when they get them back, they will be doing an analysis of the results.
Houston, Columbia, comm check. From the brand new RDM Space Tab module on Air to Ground 1.
Columbia Houston, Laura, you're loud and clear on air to ground one.
We're thrilled to be in this beautiful new laboratory and anxious to get going on 16 days just packed full of science from many, many different disciplines. And we're thankful for all the hard work of the Space Hab team.
And Laura, thanks for those great words. You've got big smiles down here, and we're all looking forward to working with you for those days.